take two. My mic just cut out from me like halfway through. I didn't even notice. And here we are. Welcome. Today we're going to talk about grading the Calgary Flames during the pause. Now, before we get started, I just want to ask you to please like, subscribe, hit that notification bell, which will alert you when my next video comes out, which will be about the Buffalo Sabres. I almost forgot there. Now, the last team I graded was the Carolina Hurricanes over there, and I'm shooting these videos in reverse alphabetical order. I'm grading all 31 NHL teams, and I'll put up links up top over the most recent clubs that I've shot so you can view them at your leisure, or you can just as easily check them out on my playlist. Now, the Flames, yeah? Let's talk about that. Now, for the first season in a while, Brad Treliving, their GM, didn't make a lot of major moves. With the exception, of course, trading Lucic for Neil during the summer there. They made that little swap. And, you know, towards the deadline, he had to pick up some pieces, some depth defensemen from the Kings and the Blackhawks, because he had almost half his D went down with injuries. Now, everyone, it's not a surprise, will tell you that they overachieved last season. Four or five players had, like, career years, and a lot of them did not do that again this year. So a lot of their numbers slipped, with the exception of their special teams, crazy enough, but we'll get to that in a second. Now, they lost their last game of the season. They were 6-3-1 in their last 10. They finished off with 79 points, good for third in the Pacific. Only 4 points behind the dreaded enemy, Edmonton Oilers, and seven behind the Vegas Golden Knights, who are in first. Of course, the Vancouver Canucks, who sit just outside a wild card spot, were only 1 point behind them, and they had a game in hand. But, of course, none of that matters now because of the 24-team playoff format. Now, the Hockey News, the magazine, had them ranked, had their prospect pool ranked 29th in the league. And part of the reason why that's depleted, of course, because a lot of those prospects graduated to the team. And they got a lot of young players up there now. Now, their number one overall prospect is Juuso Välimäki, who's supposed to play this year, of course. He tore his ACL. He's still on the LTIR. Will he play in playoffs? Who knows? I don't know. But let's talk about some stats, and I'll throw at your face really fast here. Starting with those surprising special team numbers. Now, their power play, which was 18th last season, was 12th. This season, their penalty kill, which was 21st last year, is now 8th. Wow, where did that come from? Gustafsson really helped on that part. Well, somewhat on the power play. He was only there since February, I guess. And then, of course, Forbert on the penalty kill. They put him on the number one unit there, too. Now, wins, they were 16th this season as opposed to 2nd last season. Points, they were 17th as opposed to 3rd last year. Goals for, they were 20th as opposed to 3rd last season. What a huge drop. Goals against, they were 15th as opposed to 9th last season. Now, their face-off win percentage was 22nd this year. Their shots against were 24th. Their shots for were 15th. And a few quick pointers, points here. On the NHL point leader list, the top Calgary Flame was Tkachuk, who I think led the team for the first time in points. He was in the number 36 spot with 61 points, and the next best Flame was Johnny Gaudreau, who at the 47th spot had 58 points. Michael Backlund was in a tie for second in the league in the shorthanded goal category with 3. And Elias Lindholm was tied for 3rd in the league with game-winning goals with 7. Now, the injuries, I've sort of already mentioned them to you with Välimäki being out all season. In February, Hamonic and Giordano went out with injuries, and in March, it was Hanifin. So they had some tough weather there that they had to row through. Now, let's talk about some players and their stats, starting with the goaltenders. Beginning with David Rittich. Who at age 27 now, he'll be 28 in August, 6'3", 206 pounds. He's signed for one more season at $2.75 million, and in 48 games, he had a .907 save percentage. Yeah, it's about league average, maybe a little lower. In 45 games last season, he was a .911. and that was his career year. So is he their goalie of the future or not? 28 years old, do you think you would know by now? I know goalies are a weird animal. Sometimes they don't even, you know, come out of their shell till 30, but I don't know. Then Cam Talbot, who they signed for 1 year, former Edmonton Oiler as well, he had a pretty decent season. He only played 26 games, but had a .919 save percentage. He'll be a UFA, and what do? Do they re-sign this guy? Who re-signs him, and what kind of money do they give him, really? Because he hasn't had these kind of numbers since his second year with Edmonton in 2016-17, where he went into the playoffs, that team, and they had a .924 save percentage. So that's a bit of a big question mark there. Their next best goaltender on the prospect list is ranked overall seventh, and that's Dustin Wolf. And he looks like he's quite a ways away. He's only 18 years old. Now, let's talk about the defense here, starting with their top three point getters. Giordano leads the list at 36 years old, played 60 games, had 5 goals, 31 points. That's their most. What a huge drop from last year when he had something like over 70 points. Ouch. He was a +2, averaged 23.53 a game. That's most on the team, and I want to say it's top 15 in the league. Second on the point list here is Anderson, 23-year-old, played 70 games, had 5 goals, 22 points, was a -7, averaged 19.56 a game. And then third on this list is Hanifin, who has a lot of the same numbers here. He's also 23, also played 70 games, also had 5 goals and 22 points. But he was a -12, which was the worst on defense on this team, averaged 21.10 a game. And that's it. I wanted to touch on Valimaki quickly. Now, he did play 24 games last season with the Flames, had 3 points, was a -2 in 20 games. In the AHL last season, he had 14 points, was a +9. But you look at his WHL numbers before that, and he's over a, well over a point per game player. So I know they're itching to get him going. Will he be ready for the playoffs in probably mid-July? I don't know. I don't know. I know Flame fans are crossing their fingers. I also wanted to touch on Oliver Shillington, because over half their defense are going to be UFAs next season. And there's one RFA as well. So they got to make some choices. I don't know if they can keep both Brody and Hamonic. And maybe a player like Shillington, you know, climbs into that bottom pairing spot at the very least. Now, he had 48 games this season, played and had 7 points, -6. In the AHL, he only played 3 games, but he had 3 goals. He played 38 games for them last season, too, 8 points, +3. AHL in 18 games, he had 14 points. He looks like he could be ready. So we'll see how that goes. And let's talk about forwards now, starting with their point leaders, their top four, Tkachuk, who's 22 years old. I think it's the first season he's leading the team in points in 69 games, 23 goals, 61 points, -5, averaged .818. Then there's Johnny Gaudreau, who's second at 26 years old, played 70 games, 18 goals, 58 points. What a drop for him. Didn't he have over like 80 or so, 90-ish last season? He was a -10, averaged 18.47 a game. Then there's Lindholm, who's third at age 25, also played 70 games, had 29 goals, most on the team, 54 points, -8, averaged 19.43 a game. That's the most amongst all forwards, but I think that's also because he plays on the first power play unit, on the second penalty kill unit, if I stand corrected there. According to Left Wing Lock. Now, fourth on the point list here is Sean Monahan, who at age 25 also played 70 games, had 22 goals, 48 points, -16, tied for worst on the team. A couple of other quick notes here. Derek Ryan, their third line center, who's 33, had the best plus-minus on the team at +9. He had 29 points. And then what's up with Sam Bennett? When is it going to happen? He's 23 years old now. He was a first-round draft pick. He has that pedigree, and where are the points? Where are the goals? I know he's remolding himself as a grinder and, you know, energy guy, but still, 12 points. Ouch. And then I wanted to touch on a lighter note on Andrew Mangiapane. Love saying that name. He had a very good season. At 24 years old, he's 5'10", 185 pounds, plays that left wing on the second line now, also plays center, and in 68 games, 17 goals, 32 points, plus four. You compare his former seasons, last season with Calgary, he had 13 points, plus 11 in 44 games. And the season before that, in 10 games, he had no points. So, and then in the AHL, he's over a point a game player. So it's nice to see him progressing and get a permanent spot in this lineup. Really interested to see how he does in the playoffs, of course. Now, then there's Dylan Dubé, who might be Andrew Mangiapane part two. I just wanted to say his name again. Dylan Dubé, in 45 games, had 6 goals, 16 points. In the plus-minus category, he was a zero. But in the AHL, he had 13 games, 13 points, plus two. In 25 games last year with Calgary, 5 points, plus two. And then in the AHL, in 37 games, 39 points. So he's on the same sort of path there, and hopefully they can get some more depth scoring with him as well. Now, that's about it. How do I grade this team? I could give him a C plus, B minus. I'll give him a B minus. I guess most of that's attached to the fall they had from how well they did last season. And I think they're somewhere in between this team overall. They definitely need some, more pieces on defense. They need another depth score. They need a solid goaltender. Robin Leonard, maybe? In the offseason? I don't know. It's possible. Anything, I guess. Because David Riddick's 28 years old now. How would you grade this team? Please let me know in the comment section down below. I would love to hear your thoughts. And that's it. That's all. Thank you so much for your support. Really appreciate it. Please don't forget to hit like and subscribe. And hey, in these crazy times we're living in right now, stay safe out there. And if you can, stay home. Thanks again, and see you soon.